Okay, so we're going to replace these three. I've got the replacements here for it. And just to give you a bit of a 3D sensation here of where things are, I'll just move this a little bit here. You can see my blue camera sticking out there. Okay, let's look through that blue camera. And that's what we get. Just adjusting my volume levels there. Okay, so we'll nip this off. These are probably okay, the capacitors. Be interesting to test them. Wish I had a really good capacitor tester, because I don't. And because I'd love to test these as I remove them. And there are some things you can get that'll test capacitors accurately in the circuit. And I just have not availed myself of such a thing. And you're bouncing around there in the camera. That one. This one is the 0.05. Oops. Oopsie, oopsie, oopsie. Oh, that didn't go very good. Soldering iron's not in the best of shape here. I think it's got some rubber plastic all over it. Yeah, so I let somebody else use my soldering iron. Uh-oh. Not gonna go. Not gonna go because the other wire's too corroded. Just want to abrade it a little bit. Okay, we'll try that again. See if I made enough difference here. poor soldering iron. What the heck? What's that? What? What is that? What happened there? It's like a shell came off the outside of my soldering iron. That's really extra weird. You know what I think is happening? I've got a piece of cloth over here that I keep wiping the soldering iron on, and I think it's just contaminating it with... It's probably some kind of plastic. Look at that stupid situation here. Okay. What that was. Okay, let's try again. I'm gonna have to do something about the soldering iron here. It's got some kind of coating on it, and it's not conducting heat or anything here. I'm gonna do a major effort on the soldering iron. Never had to do that before. Let me get a different material here. Wasn't any better. Oops. You know, I've never had a soldering iron go like this before. Yeah, it's got some kind of coating on it. Oh. This is just crazy. Probably ruining the tip here with the file. Never done anything like this to a soldering iron before. Still not flowing. Isn't that just the strangest deal here? Push. Think God, I'm getting smoked out of my shop at this point. Jeez, I'm stumped here with a soldering iron that won't solder. Well, I'm going to have to take a little while here and get my soldering iron back into shape. So think you can see what I'm up to, so I won't bother filming it. Hope I get it better. Okay, I think I'm back in business here. That's my fixed up soldering iron. So, boy, I tell you, don't lend your soldering iron. Never lend your soldering iron. Let's see if this works now. I may have let it cool down. Oh, no. Very strange. Some kind of material got on this soldering iron. And really, really messed up the end of it. Idea some of the my cleaning efforts here off camera. A lot of wire to work with here. You may get some strange effects from the frame rate on my camera. No, the wire's not really doing what it looks like it's doing. That would be a little... Come on, you can be long enough. If you try. Much holding that. You know what? I didn't scrape this wire. I'm going to run into the same solder problem, probably. Okay. Make a small blood donation there. Yeah, in case you're wondering why I jumped, I didn't jump because I got a shock. I jumped because I poked myself with a piece of wire. Almost did it again there. Not a lot holding that. We get to have a close-up look at a fairly poor connection here I'm making. Okay, it's got a bit of a grip there. And the soldering iron looks normal again. Okay, oh, I might as well solder in these guys here. Pretty good. Okay, get rid of this. Get rid of this. And now we'll go after this guy. Which guy? This guy. capacitor's got pretty heavy leads on it. Exactly where that piece of wire went, I don't know. Heavier pliers for this wire. There, that little piece can join the other one. Okay, so those are the three capacitors changed out now. So I'm trying to position the capacitors where when I put the radio back in they won't get bumped because they're sticking out too far this way. I get bumped into shorting out against something. That's pretty good. I still got a piece of wire there to trim off. There we go. Ooh, it's close there. Okay. I think from here we're into just basically doing an alignment. So far, so good.